In 1997, chess master Garry Kasparov went to battle against the IBM supercomputer Deep Blue in a landmark chess match. After 6 games, Deep Blue prevailed, making the first time that a computer defeated a reigning world champion under tournament conditions. For decades, poker has been a difficult and important grand challenge problem for the field of artificial intelligence. Because poker involves hidden information, you do not know your opponent's cards, and success requires bluffing and other strategies that do not apply to chess and other games. This twist has made poker resistant to AI techniques that produce breakthroughs in these other games. However, in 2015, an artificial intelligence once again squared off against world-class human gamers. This time, at the Brains vs. Artificial Intelligence Challenge at the River Casino in Pittsburgh, the ultimate supremacy of humans or machines was determined not by chess, but by an epic 14-day and 80,000 hands of No Limit Texas Hold'em. Representing the machines was Claudico, an AI from the same lab at Carnegie Mellon University that gave birth to Deep Blue. Fighting for the users were Jason Les, Bron Lee, Don Kim, and Doug Polk, who were four of the world's best professional players. After the match, the final chip count came in at $732,000 in favor of the human poker pros over the AI poker bot. However, not all of them fared so well. Bron Lee retained the highest lead over Claudico, ending with $529,000 more than the computer poker program. Doug Polk was up $213,000, while Don Kim bested the AI bot for $70,000. Claudico did manage to prevail over Jason Les by $80,400. All told, the humans racked up a $732,000 victory in chips, but according to CMU professor Tuomas Sandholm, who led the team of developers in the creation of Claudico, the result was technically a tie. Sandholm said that the $732,000 lead by the human poker pros may sound like a large amount, but based on the full amount of chips in play, which was 170 million, the human lead isn't large enough to define a genuine win. In reality, the winnings amounted to less than 0.5% of the total chips in play, 0.431% to be exact. As such, Sandholm said it's impossible to say the humans clearly defeated the AI poker bot. Carnegie Mellon University followed up in 2017 with another AI dubbed Liberatus. This time, rather than focusing on exploiting its opponent's mistakes, the AI focused on improving its own play, apparently a more reliable approach. Sandholm said that we looked at fixing holes in our own strategy because it makes our own play safer and easier. When you exploit opponents, you open yourself up to exploitation more and more. The researchers also upped the number of games played to 120,000 hands. The AI prevailed even though the four human players tried to conspire against it, coordinating on making strange bet sizes to confuse Liberatus. Liberatus emerged victorious after 120,000 combined hands of poker played against four human online poker pros. Liberatus's 1.7 million margin of victory combined with so many hands clears the primary bar victory with a statistical significance. So how did Liberatus manage to beat the pros? First, Liberatus was programmed with an abstraction of the game to give the bot a basic understanding of general scenarios and game theory optimal strategies. This information formed the basis of the software's move in early rounds when its human opponents did not have a read on how it was going to play. Second, as the game develops, Liberatus uses nested subgame solving. This basically takes a more detailed abstraction of the subgame and conducts an analysis of what's going on in the moment. This information is then compared to the general abstraction defined in the first instance. Finally, Liberatus was able to self-improve. After taking general and game-specific information, the bot could teach itself and refine its database of knowledge. Another way of looking at it is that Liberatus could take information obtained in the first level and rewrite it based on new information and calculations from level 2. The only shortcoming of Liberatus was that it was still playing against one other player in heads-up action. But then, in 2019, a new poker bot came up called Pluribus. This bot was developed by the same researchers in a joint project between Facebook AI. The AI was tested in two different scenarios. In one, it was one AI against five human opponents, and in the other, it was five AI players against one single human. The participating poker players in this experiment were Jimmy Chow, Seth Davis, Michael Gagliano, Anthony Gregg, Don Kim, Jason Les, Linus Loliger, Daniel McCauley, Greg Merson, Nick Petrangelo, Sean Wan, Trevor Savage, Darren Elias, Chris Ferguson, and Jacob Toole. Although poker is a game of skill, there is an extremely large luck component as well. It is common for top pros to lose money even around the course of 10,000 hands of poker simply because of bad luck. To reduce the role of luck, they used a version of the AIVAT variance reduction algorithm, which applies a baseline estimate of the value of each situation to reduce variance while keeping the samples unbiased. For example, if the bot is dealt a really strong hand like aces, AIVAT will subtract a baseline value from its winnings to counter the good luck. This adjustment allowed them to achieve statistically significant results with roughly 10 times fewer hands played. In both the cases, Pluribus was able to gain a significant advantage, winning around $5 per hand and nearly $1,000 per hour while playing against 5 human opponents. This was something that no other AI had achieved so far, which was to beat multiple strong players in the incomplete information game of No Limit Texas Hold'em in a 6-handed format, and it did so more efficiently than any other documented poker bot before it. Jason Liss admitted that he had trouble countering the bot's moves. He said, "It's an absolute monster bluffer. I would say it's a much more efficient bluffer than most humans, and that's what makes it more difficult to play against." Chris Ferguson quotes, "Pluribus is a very hard opponent to play against. It's really hard to pin him down on any kind of hand. He's also very good at making thin value bets on the river. He's very good at extracting value out of his good hands." Elias said, "Its major strength is its ability to use mixed strategies. That's the same thing that humans try to do. It's a matter of execution for humans to do this in a perfectly random way and to do it so consistently. Most people just can't do it." The core of Pluribus' strategy was computed via self-play, in which the AI plays against copies of itself without any human gameplay data used as input. The AI starts from scratch by playing randomly and gradually improves as it determines which actions and which probability distribution over those actions lead to better outcomes against earlier version of its strategy. The version of self-play used in Pluribus is an improved variant of the iterative Monte Carlo CFR algorithm. Exploring against hypothetical outcomes is possible because the AI is playing against copies of itself. If the AI wants to find out what would have happened if some other action had been chosen, then it only needs to ask itself what it would have done in response to that action. With this latest AI breakthrough, scientists have proven that they're capable of creating a poker bot that can hold its own and even come out ahead in complex 6-max scenarios. Pluribus actually confirmed one bit of conventional poker playing wisdom. It's just not a good idea to limp into a hand. The exception, of course, is if you're in the small blind. But while human players typically avoid the so-called donk betting, in which a player ends one round with a call but starts the next round with a bet, Pluribus plays donk bets far more than often against its human opponents. The findings from Pluribus research can be applied to fields such as fraud prevention and cybersecurity, as well as other fields involving multiple agent or hidden information. While there are of course potential positive benefits to come from the research, some individuals justifiably brought up concerns on the Reddit forum regarding increased ease of cheating via use of poker bots in online poker context. Some took heart in the fact that Liberatus needed major supercomputer hardware to analyze its gameplay and figure out how to improve its play. It needs 15 million core hours and 1,400 CPU cores during live play. But Pluribus needs much less processing capability. Completing its blueprint strategy in just 8 days using 12,400 core hours and 28 cores during live play. So is this the death blow for skill-based poker? Well, the algorithm was so successful that the researchers have decided not to release its code. They say it could be very dangerous for the poker community. Though bot detection has seemingly been ramped up by major poker sites in recent years, the ease and efficiency of supercomputing in the latest bot is justifiably cause for concern to online poker players. Time will tell whether or not online poker bots prevention tools can keep pace with those looking to use supercomputing technology to gain an unfair advantage in the industry. This video is powered by Bluff the Spot, the best place to learn how to win at poker from actual high-stake coaches like MMA Sherdog. Check the link in the description. And if you like this video, leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.